We are going to welcome Pastor Bobbie as she comes to bring the word. But before we do that, as I said, we're joined by all the rooms in Hillsong, Australia and Bali. And we're going to watch an important announcement from Pastor Brian and Bobbie. And we're going to watch that together. And on the back of that, Pastor Bobby's going to come and bring the word. And I'd pray that all of us at that time would honour not only the woman of God, but the word of God at that time. So come on, let's together watch this important announcement.
Well, hi, church. Bobbie and I are filled with faith for our church and everything God has in store for, well, you, for your family, for our church, and of course, in our own lives. It's been an unexpected season, and we're thankful for you all and for the incredible sense of community we share. It's been amazing to see the lean into our church online globally and the thousands of people we've been able to pray for. I never get tired of the praise reports and miracles, and especially those who are making decisions for Jesus Christ. Last year, as you know, I also received unexpected news of charges against me that alleged the concealing of information that may have been material to prosecute Frank Houston. These allegations came as a complete shock to me, and it's my intention to vigorously defend them. Well, in September last year, I learned it was necessary for me to step aside as a director of all Hillsong boards during this season, which enables me to give attention to the charge. But recently, we made a decision that may come as a big surprise to you, and I wanted you to hear it from me directly. In December, during our annual board retreat, Hillsong's external legal counsel gave the board advice regarding the current charge I'm facing, and that it would be best practice for me to step aside completely from church leadership during the court proceedings. So it's likely to be drawn out and take up most of 2022, especially considering the backlog in the courts exacerbated by the COVID pandemic. And then along with this, the board and I have been having detailed discussions around the requirements for leadership. And we've talked about the effects of the situation with my father going back many years up to the current legal case and the impact this has had on me emotionally. So the result is Hillsong's global board feel it's in my and the church's best interest for this to happen. So I've agreed to step aside from all ministry responsibilities until the end of the year. As I've said, most of you know the court case I'm facing is related to circumstances surrounding my father, and I need to be fully committed to preparation and engagement with the case and work closely with my lawyers in defending this charge. I've said, including in a prior statement, that I intend to fight the charge, and I welcome the opportunity to set the record straight. Church, we love you as much as ever. And Bobbie and I certainly value your prayers in these challenging times. We love Jesus, we love his church, and we're as committed as we've ever been to the God-given future ahead of us all. It's important to note Bobbie intends to stay fully engaged in church life, including leading the upcoming 2022 Colour Conference and, of course, Sisterhood. During 2022, I've asked Pastors Phil and Lucinda Dooley to take on the role of interim global senior pastors. The Dooleys are very well loved by many in our church, having successfully served as our youth pastors in Australia for many, many years. And then over the last 13 years, they, with their family, have resided in South Africa and have raised up a phenomenal multi-campus Hillsong Church. So Bobbie and I wholeheartedly support them and want to thank them and their family for stepping into this global role and returning to Australia for this season. I must say to our church in South Africa, Phil and Lucinda love South Africa. They love our church in South Africa, and they're as committed to the future of our church there as they've ever been. So I want to thank you personally for sharing your pastors with us in this season. I believe they will experience our church's full support as we move forward and lift up Jesus as the hope of humanity. I believe it'll be a year of divine favor. It's 50 years this week since I commenced Bible college in New Zealand, February 1972. So with 5 decades of active ministry behind us, be assured we'll make the best of the season to replenish spiritually, emotionally, and physically. I'm sure your complete support for Phil and Lucinda and your prayers and goodwill will make more difference than perhaps you even realize. We love you, church. God bless. I'm going to ask Bobby to pray for our church and for 2022 and for the Dooleys. And let's believe for a great year ahead. Amen. I'd like to encourage you to just lean in more than ever this year. Let's make it a big win. Let's decide that we're going to give our biggest support spiritually, physically, be in the room, be in the house. Can't wait to see our church again filled with incredible people. Lean in financially and in every other way. And so come on, Bobby, let's pray together.
Amen. Wherever you are, church, why don't you stand to your feet? Amen. We're going to stand and we're going to pray and we're going to believe for the Spirit of God to be outpoured, to continue to be outpoured upon our church. And, you know, this announcement really gives me no joy. But you know what? We shall rejoice and we shall press on, because that is the nature of thy kingdom come in our lives, in your lives, and in this church and across the earth. So Father God, we stand with our beloved church around the world.
Amen.
And Father God, we commit ourselves into your hand yet again with humility of heart. And Father God, we thank you for the grace and the favor and the goodness and the good times, Father God, and even the challenging times that we have endured and walked through and rejoiced in over the years.
Yes.
And Lord, again, with humility of heart, we commit our house to you. We commit Hillsong Church to you and the beautiful people who make up this house. We pray, Father God, that 2022, regardless of what the world looks like, shall be a year of favor in the Amen. House of God and in the church of Jesus Christ, that your face shall be upon us, that you shall go before us and beside us and behind us, and that you will continue to pour out your Spirit. Father God, as Brian has said, this is a year of favor in Jesus' name, and that comes from Isaiah, and it talks about the Spirit of God being poured out upon us in order that we can actually rise up and be the church of Jesus Christ. And so, Father, we commit ourselves to you, we commit our family to you, we commit our church family to you, and we pray, have your divine will. Father God, right now, as a global family, we stand and we bring Pastors Phil and Lucinda yes. to you, and we thank you for their life and for their devotion and for their great love of kingdom and house and people. And Lord, we commit them to you and pray that your Spirit shall rest upon them, Father God, that you will anoint them and you will smear them with grace and ability as we together, as a global family, continue to rebuild, to Thank believe you, that Jesus. You can rescue and restore and rebuild, Father God, across this earth. So God, Lord, with humility of heart, we commit ourselves to you.
Thank you.
And everyone who believes it said amen. Amen. Amen, church. We love you.
Amen.
Heart and soul.
God bless. And you're speaking this morning.
I am speaking this morning.
It'll be great. Wherever you guys are around the world, I pray you'll have a great Sunday. Amen.
Amen. We love you.